Toxic chemicals called PFAS are being spread across the globe in alarming amounts, and a new report warns about the dangers of these chemicals and how they're spreading through the air. Ring of Fire's Farron Cousins joins me now to talk about that and many other issues. Farron, of course, we've been following this story for almost a decade now. Honestly, we were some of the first people reporting it because we were trying that case up in the Ohio River Valley where 70,000 people were exposed to this cancer-causing chemical, and seemed like the government said it's okay. Looks like they're doing it again. Now we're spreading it by air. Let's pick up on this story a little bit.
Right. This is actually a rather terrifying story for everyone involved, because we have found these PFAS chemicals, and essentially every human being in the planet right now has this chemical in them, most likely. And usually it goes through the water. That's how most of it was coming in. But now we're finding out that when you send your trash away that has these PFAS chemicals in it, whether you know it or not, it gets incinerated. And over in Europe, they've actually been doing studies. We're ignoring it here for the moment. But in Europe, they've done studies and found, oh my God, we're burning the trash. We're sending the PFAS, you know, dozens and dozens of miles away from these incinerators. And we don't know how badly this is going to hurt people, because we don't know what exactly happens to these chemicals when you heat them to these temperatures. Do they become worse? Do they break down?
We do know a little bit. We learned in the trial. I tried five cases back to back in the Ohio River Valley. People that were suffering from testicular cancer, kidney cancer, complete systemic kinds of problems that were killing people by the dozens up in the Ohio River Valley. There was a movie that was made about it. It was called Dark Waters. I tried those cases for that lawyer. Rob Ballot, brilliant, brilliant lawyer who stayed with this, did the investigation, and just dogged these people. Another movie that tells the story is The Devil We Know. But the story is still not getting through to government, okay?
Right.
To have the Biden administration say, yeah, this is okay, let's incinerate it, even though we know that it first of all, it never goes anywhere. If it's in the soil, it's in the soil for a million years. If it's in the water, it's in the literally a million years. If it's in the water, it's in a million years. If it's in your body, it stays in your body your entire life.
Right. That's why these are called these forever chemicals. Folks need to understand that. These don't go away. They're not going to break down. And one of the things we are finding out, of course, about this, you know, incinerating it and sending it through the air, is that sometimes they do actually break down.
Mm-hmm.
And then what the scientists have now found is, oh God, once they're in the air, they actually start to reform.
Yeah.
And they create new kinds of PFAS chemicals. And these
they're mutations.
Right.
They're mutations.
Like the different variants of COVID we have seen.
Right.
And we're creating these horrible new cancer-causing chemicals.
Well, isn't the real problem here? It's like the story we did a couple of months ago, where the Biden administration says, now we're going to allow paraquat, the most deadly herbicide on the planet. It's so deadly that China makes it in China, outside Beijing. They don't allow it to be sold in China. The UK makes it. They don't allow it to be sold in the UK. They ship it to the United States. Switzerland makes it, but they don't allow it to be sold in their country. They ship it to the United States. So we know that we've got an administration that is completely asleep at the wheel on environmental issues. They're spraying this from the air when no other country allows that. We allow it in the United States. It causes Parkinson's disease. So this story that we're talking about on PFAS is just another iteration of this administration simply ignoring what they promised they were going to do when they were running for office, and that is, we're going to get control over the environment.
Well, you know, I do want to add to that, too, because a lot of people think that, okay, well, obviously Republicans are horrible on environmental issues.
They are.
So all you got to do is vote Democrats and we're going to solve these problems. No, folks.
Yeah.
No, absolutely not. You got to look at what the EPA is doing, which right now is pretty much nothing.
Well, you and I talk about this all the time. You know, we have this one, it's kind of this myopic view of our politics, right? We think if it's Democrat, they're looking out for consumers. They're not. On social issues, they're great. Republicans are awful. On consumer issues and issues that protect our environment and protect our health, Democrats are just as bad as Republicans. And this is a great example. Paraquat and now this, We're just going to let it out there, and we're not going to worry about what it does to consumers.